بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه كثير. أما بعد، so إن شاء الله تعالى today will be the first class for الدروس المهمة لعامة الأمة أو شرح دروس المهمة لعامة الأمة. The explanation of important lessons by Sheikh Imam Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah bin Baz رحمه الله تعالى. So Sheikh bin Baz goes on to mention in his muqaddimah, introduction, all praises due to Allah, the Lord of all that exists. The successful ending is for those who have taqwa, piety, righteousness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his prophet with blessings and mention his name, meaning the name Prophet in the highest place. Likewise, upon his family and upon all of his companions. The following is a short work to explain what every Muslim needs to know about the religion of Islam. I called it important lessons for every Muslim. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cause the Muslims to benefit from it and that he accept it from me. Indeed, he's the most generous. He's the most generous. So we're going to skip the first few chapters of the sharh of the ayat. We're going to start with the five pillars of Al-Islam. The five pillars of Al-Islam. So the Shaykh bin Baz, may Allah have mercy upon him, said the pillars of Islam, clarifying the five pillars of Islam, the first and the greatest of which is to bear witness that la ilaha illallah wa anna muhammadan rasulullah. The meaning of it, or the translation of it, that there is nothing worthy of worship in truth except Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, with explanation of their meanings and the conditions of la ilaha illallah and its meaning. La ilaha illallah. So la ilaha, that's the first part of the shahada, or the first part of the shahada. So la ilaha, negate all that is worshipped other than Allah. Illa Allah, illa Allah, other than so illa Allah, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So la ilaha, this first part, negation, la ilaha, there is nothing worthy of worship. إلا من المعبود هي. طيب إلا الله. The other part, إلا الله. Except Allah, that is the one who should be worshipped alone, and he's the one who deserves to be worshipped. So this is called the two pillars of التوحيد. If someone asks you, what are the two pillars of التوحيد? Say, النفي والإثبات. النفي والإثبات. Which means negation and affirmation. Negation and affirmation. So to negate, la ilaha. طيب, illa Allah. So you negate, there is nothing worthy of worship in truth. So when a person becomes Muslim except Islam, he will say, a Muslim should understand that when he say la ilaha, illa Allah, mean that nothing should be worshipped in truth, and no one deserves to be worshipped in truth except Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Na'am. Then the Sheikh goes on to mention the the conditions, شروط لا إله إلا الله, the شروط of لا إله إلا الله, the conditions of لا إله إلا الله, which means there is nothing worthy of worship in truth except Allah. First, knowledge. طيب, knowledge that negates ignorance. Knowledge that negates ignorance. Second, certainty. Certainty that negates, which negates doubts. Certainty which negates doubts. So first we said knowledge which negates, that negates ignorance. الجهل, العلم يضاده الجهل. Certainty which negates doubt. Sincerity, sincerity which الإخلاص, which negates shirk. Truth which negates denial. We have mentioned now so far four conditions. We have mentioned so far four conditions. So then. Eight, six, abandoning mission, which negates abandoning. Seven, acceptance, which negates rejection. Acceptance, which negates rejection. Rejection, have one. And some of them add number eight, which is to disbelieve in الطاغوت, الكفر بالطاغوت, to disbelieve in all that is worshipped other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, التوحيد has two pillars. If someone asks you, what are the two pillars of التوحيد? We reply, النفي والإثبات. النفي والإثبات. النفي which negation. لا إله. You are negating. You are negating. Meaning there is nothing worthy of worship in truth. إلا الله. Affirmation. Except Allah. Because there is other gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نعم. There is other gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are they true gods? They are false gods. The true ilah is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. As for the conditions, there are eight, some mentioned seven. The one that is famous, famous and known is are seven conditions. But some scholars add number eight, which is al-kufr bi-taghut, to disbelieve in all that is been worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mentioned, let us repeat, knowledge negate ignorance, certainty negate doubt, sincerity negate shirk, truth negate denial, fifth, love which negate hate, you know, you love for it. Number six, submission, which negates abandoning. Number seven, acceptance, which negates rejection. Number eight, disbelief in all that is being worshipped. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then the Sheikh bin Baz, may Allah have mercy upon him, goes on say, clarifying the testimony, Muhammadun Rasulullah. So now this is the first part of a shahada. So you can say shahada or shahadatan. Ash-shahadatu or shahadatan. You can mention as a singular or plural. clarifying the testimony of Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which includes to believe what he informs us. Ta'atuhu fima amar. So when you say, I bear witness Muhammad, the messenger of Allah, has a meaning. Ta'atuhu fima amar. Wa tasdiquhu fima akhbar. Wal ibti'adu an ma naha anhu wa zajar. Wa an la yu'bad Allah illa bima shara'a. Ayy Nabi alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. نعم so إلا بما شرع الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام so to believe وطاعته فيما أمر to obey his commandments تصديقه فيما أخبر to believe what informed us of and ابتعاد عن ما نهى عنه وزجر to abstain from his prohibitions and the last one not to worship Allah except with what the messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam legislated. طيب, that's the meaning of it. You don't worship Allah based upon your desires. We don't worship Allah based upon our desires, our feelings. No, based upon the teaching of the Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. The Sharia al-Muhammadiyya. Sharia al-Muhammadiyya. Because Allah, side point, Allah said, "Inna al-Din 'inda Allah al-Islam." Verily, the religion with Allah is al-Islam. So all the prophets and messengers came with Islam, but they came with different Sharia. That's why they say Sharia or Sharia al-Isawiyya of this religion, which valid for every place, every time, is then Sheikh, he said, next, a student should learn about the what is left from the five pillars of Islam. Zakat, Sheikh will speak about it as well. The rest of Arkan al-Islam. The Sheikh goes on to say, defining Islam. What is Islam? ما هو معنى الإسلام? Define Islam. Islam means for you to submit yourself to Allah. Islam means for you to submit yourself to Allah. By making your worship sincere and pure for Him alone. So Islam means for you to submit yourself to Allah and by making your worship sincere and pure for Him alone. By obeying Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by absolving yourself of a shirk and its people. Then the Sheikh goes on to say shirk to associate partners with Allah in worship. Was the creed of the Arabs before the advent or the advent of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. So Sheikh mentioned, yeah, what is Islam? You can't say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, then you submit to your desires. You submit to your forefathers' culture, or you mix Islam with Christianity. No. When you become a Muslim, you free yourself from anything that opposes the teaching of Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam. You know, anything that opposes the teaching of the Prophet, you know, you free yourself from it. So then he goes on to mention, what is a shirk? He mentioned the shirk to associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a shirk to believe there is another creator besides Allah. That is a shirk, no doubt, shirk in the Rububiyyah. But the shirk that the prophets and messengers want and guessed, because majority of people believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Fir'aun, believed in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So the shirk, it was shirk in worship. Shirk in worship. Now, Al-Bukhari narrated or collected or narrated on the author that Abu Raja' Al-Utaridi said, we used to worship stones and we would find a stone that was better than the one we were worshipping. We would throw the former away and start worshipping the latter. If we couldn't find a stone, we would gather help, often we would gather like amount of dirt. Then we would bring a sheep and milk it over the pile, and then we would walk around it, subhanallah, as a ritual worship. So subhanallah, they used to worship stones, make something from it. Then if they find another stone better than it, they'll throw the first one, start worshiping the second one. And if they cannot find a stone, they will get clay or dirt, you know, clay together, you know, subhanallah, start bringing a sheep and milk it over the pile, and then they start walk around it as an act of worship. Then the Shaykh goes on to say, in many different verses, the Quran clarified for us the state of the nations in general before the advent of the Prophet's message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاءُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And they worship besides Allah things that hurt them not, nor benefit them. And they say, these are our intercessors with Allah. Another verse, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. And those who has taken protectors and helpers besides him say, we worship them only in order to bring us closer to Allah or nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh bin Baz, may Allah have mercy upon him, Imam Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah bin Baz, is mentioning what was the shirk of the people before Allah sent النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Allah mentioned, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاءُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And they worship besides Allah things that hurt them not, nor benefit them. And they say, these are our intercessors with Allah. The other verse, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. And those who take protectors and helpers besides him say, we worship them only to bring us closer or nearer to Allah. And Allah mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ وَإِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا آبَاءَنَا والله أمرنا بها قل إن الله لا يأمر بالفحشاء أتقولون على الله ما لا تعلمون. Verily, we made the shayateen, the devils, protectors and helpers for those who believe not. And when they when they commit a fahisha, evil act, evil deed, going around the Kaaba in a naked state, every kind of unlawful sexual intercourse, etc., they say, we found our fathers doing it and Allah has commanded us of it, saying, nay, Allah never commands of fahisha. Do you say of Allah what you know not? Surah Al-A'raf. Another verse, Allah said, إِنَّهُمْ اتَّخَذُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Surely they took the shayateen, devils, as a protectors and helpers besides Allah, instead of Allah, and consider that they are guided. They think they are guided, subhanallah. So the Shaykh, subhanallah, bringing the ayat, and this is the way of Ahl-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah. they back up their claims with the Quran and the Sunnah, with the ayat al-wadihat, al-bayyinat. So the Sheikh is mentioning here, what was the shirk of the people before the Nabi alayhi salatu wassalam, before Allah sending the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Because you know, subhanAllah, many Muslims, to be honest, not just some, many Muslims, when you speak to them and ask them, ماذا كان شرك العرب؟ Or ما هو شرك العرب؟ What was the shirk of Al-Arab before Al-Islam? Or during the life of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام? Why Allah called them kuffar? They don't know. They think God because they did not believe in Allah as the creator and the provider. That's when Qawa'id al-Arba, in the four principles of shirk, Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab explains what was the shirk that the prophets and messengers warned and guessed, and what was the tawheed that they called people to with ayat and ahadith. Subhanallah. And we have these people of misguidance and deviations try to belittle the risala. The shaykh, barakallahu fikum. So they used to say, we are not clean, we are not pure, so we cannot call upon Allah directly. So what they do, they used to set up intermediaries between them and Allah. They believed Allah is the creator. They believed Allah is the provider, the sustainer, the one that controls everything. They believed in that. They believed in the rububiyyah, generally speaking. But in uluhiyyah, they will associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by going through righteous people or a prophet or stones and trees or angels. And yet Allah called them kuffar. And they say they are shufa'a. So we only use these objects or the prophet and the messengers to or the righteous people to in order for them to intercede for us. Another one, to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sheikh mentioned other verses. He mentioned there are many other verses that shows a similar imparts a similar meaning. Shows similar meaning other than the Quran, the saying of the Prophet and of the trustworthy historians give us a good glimpse of the state of the previous nations. Likewise, if you want to know about the Arab nations or the Arab nation or the other nations in their shirk, you go back to the Sunnah of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam or to the trustworthy historians. So the people used to worship many things. Subhanallah. Some of them used to worship jinn. Naam, they used to worship jinn. So a shirk, to direct any act of worship to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, any act of worship that is belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you go direct to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is a shirk. Billah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the Messenger of Allah invites all of them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَلِمَاتِهِ وَاتَّبِعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. The meaning of the verse, say, O Muhammad, O mankind, verily, I am sent to you all as the messenger of Allah, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. None has a right to be worshipped but he, until the end of the verse. Then the Sheikh goes on to mention the other verse, Alif Lam Ra, كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور بإذن ربهم إلى صراط العزيز الحميد. Alif Lam Ra. This is a book which we have revealed to you in order that you might lead mankind out of darkness into light. By the Lord's permission, to the path of Almighty, the owner of all praise. Another verse, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ila Allahi bi'idhnih wa sirajan munira. O Prophet, verily we have sent you as a witness and a bearer of glad tidings and a warner and as one who invites to Allah by his permission and as a lamp spreading light. And the Shaykh goes on, subhanAllah, looks at the, again, the ulama of Sunnah, many verses, subhanAllah, there's many verses the Shaykh brings. The other verse, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ. And they were commanded not except to worship Allah sincerely, حُنَفَاءَ, and to make the religion sincerely to him. There's many verses, mashallah, the Shaykh brings. Then the Shaykh, so the Shaykh is bringing the verse about showing that the ibadah is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And showing that Nabi Asasim came to call people to worship Allah sincerely and to make the religion sincerely to him and to warn them against the shirk. Against the shirk. Also in the Quran, Allah uses Lord, his lordship, which they believe in, to establish his worship. طيب لأن الربوبية تستلزم الألوهية. If you believe Allah is the creator of everything and that he is the owner of everything, then why you not worship in him alone? So inshallah we stop here and we continue next week inshallah ta'ala. So if you have any question or something, you're more than welcome, or correction. Barakallahu feekum. So inshallah, these classes will be maximum 30 minutes, 35 minutes. In order for, because you wanna, some people that cannot listen to a talk more than an hour or more than 30 minutes. So these classes want everyone to benefit from it, inshallah ta'ala. So I don't want to make it longer. So it will be 30 minutes, maximum inshallah, 35 minutes. And this is one of the books that I will highly recommend everyone to buy. Let me show it here. Important lessons. For new Muslims, for, you know, everyone should have this book. If you're a beginner or not, you should have this book. This is a nice risale of Imam Abdul Aziz. This book comprises the whole deen. Subhanallah. It comprises the whole deen. And I advise my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all, try to memorize the conditions and the pillars of La ilaha illallah. Likewise, the four conditions or the meaning of Muhammadun Rasulullah alayhi salatu wassalam. So we stop here inshallah ta'ala. Wallahu ta'ala a'azzu wa a'lam. وصلى الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.